This video will demonstrate an upgrade to PI Buffer Subsystem version 4.3 from a previous version of PI Buffer Subsystem. Before we get started, let's quickly go over some of the system requirements. From the PI Live library, we can see that PI Buffer Subsystem supports both 32-bit and 64-bit client and server Windows operating systems, starting from Windows Server 2003 SP2. Any destination PI Data Archive server will need to be version 3.4.375 or later. We always recommend running the latest version for the best performance. Finally, if you're configuring buffering for PI API interfaces, then you will need to get PI ICU version 1.4.15 or later. If you're configuring buffering for AFSDK or PI SDK clients, then you'll need PI AF Client 2014 or later, or PI SDK 2014 or later. So let's go over what the current configuration of my interface machine looks like. Within PI ICU, you'll notice that I already have two PI interfaces configured and sending data. So the first instance is writing data to Carbon, which is the name of my PI Data Archive collective. This collective has two members. The second instance is writing to Graphite, which is the name of an independent PI Data Archive server. Keep in mind that this is an upgrade, and this may require the machine to be restarted or may require service stoppage time, so please make sure you have either the appropriate downtime scheduled or you have interface failover configured to minimize the data downtime during the upgrade. So let's take a look at the current buffering configuration. So once I've opened up tools buffering within PI ICU, we can see that the current option is to enable buffering with PI Buffer Subsystem. And then if I go to my buffering settings, you'll notice that I have one custom setting here, which is to have my buffer queue files located in this custom path, which is D-Drive PI BuffSS queues. Within the buffered servers list, we can see the two members of my Carbon PI Data Archive collective listed here. So basically, any data being written to my collective is going to be fanned and replicated and buffered. The data that's being sent to Graphite, which is my independent PI Data Archive server, currently is not buffered. One of the main new features of PI Buffer Subsystem 4.3 is that it can buffer to multiple servers or multiple PI Data Archive collectives at the same time. So once I finish the upgrade, I should be able to buffer my data to Graphite as well. And finally, if we go to the PI Buffer Subsystem Service tab, you'll notice that I have my PI Buffer Subsystem Service actually running under a custom domain service account. This is to follow the security best practices. Okay, so let's get the install kit. The install kit can be found at our tech support page at techsupport.osisoft.com. Once your browser's there, you can go to the downloads page. At the downloads page, type in PI Buffer Subsystem for the product name and click search. Here are the results returned. Since I'm going to be configuring buffering for PI API based interfaces, the one that I'm going to get is the PI Interface Configuration Utility Install Kit, version 1.4.16.79a. Okay, so I already have the install kit downloaded and saved in my D drive install kits folder. So once I'm there, I'm going to right-click the install kit and run as administrator. It then prompts me for a location to extract the installation file, so I'm just going to put it into the same folder. At the installation splash screen, I can see that PI Buffer Subsystem version 4.3 is one of the modules that will be upgraded. At this point in the installation, it will actually warn me of all the services that need to be stopped. As mentioned before, the upgrade may need to stop your PI interface services, so please make sure you have the downtime scheduled or interface failover configured to minimize your data downtime. Alright, so now the upgrade is mostly finished, and we can see that it started up all of the services that were stopped during the upgrade. including my two PI interfaces. So the installation is now complete, and on the final splash screen, we can see that PI Buffer Subsystem has been successfully installed. Okay, so now that it's successfully installed, the first thing that I want to check is to make sure that I'm still receiving data from my PI interfaces. So I'm going to open up PI SMT. Okay, I'm going to connect to all three of my PI Data Archive servers and use the Current Values plugin to make sure I'm receiving current data from my PI interfaces. So I'm just going to pull up a couple tags that I know are being written to from the PI interfaces on this machine. And I'm going to update it. And we can see that on all three servers, I am indeed getting current values from the PI interfaces on this machine. Okay, so the data looks good. But how do we know that it's actually buffered? So what we can do is open PI ICU. So once PI ICU is loaded, we can go to Tools, Buffering. And you'll notice now that instead of loading the traditional buffering page within PI ICU, it opens Buffering Manager. Buffering Manager is a new GUI tool that's included with PI Buffer Subsystem version 4.3. This tool is basically a dashboard that shows real-time health status for all of your PI Data Archive servers that are configured for buffering. Additionally, it's also the central place where you can make all the configuration changes for the PI Buffer Subsystem settings. Okay, so on this initial screen, this is what we call the global level. So at the global level, I can see that I've had 8,500 total events sent. So if I had multiple servers here, this would be the total count across all of my servers. If I wanted to look at the counters just for my Carbon PI Data Archive Collective, I can click here. Now, since I don't have any other PI Data Archive collectives or servers configured for buffering, the counter here on this page is going to be the same as at the global level. Furthermore, if I wanted to drill down to individual members, I can do that by selecting the member at the bottom here. So let's say I wanted to look at the events sent for Carbon 12. So once I'm here, this is the physical server level, which means it will show the counters just for that individual PI Data Archive collective member. So I can see that there's been 5,327 total events sent to this Carbon 12 member. So what about my Graphite server? Well, before the upgrade, the Graphite PI Data Archive server was not configured for buffering. So after the upgrade, it still is not configured for buffering. To do this, I can follow the procedure outlined in the video, Configure PI Buffer Subsystem for PI API Interfaces. If you want to configure buffering for additional PI API interfaces, please watch that video as well. So before the upgrade, I pointed out a couple of custom settings for my PI Buffer Subsystem. So one of those settings was the queue path. And you'll notice here at the physical server level, it has retained that queue path, so it's still saved in the D drive PI BuffSS queues directory. The other thing that was customized about my PI Buffer Subsystem configuration was that I had the service running under a custom domain service account. So if I open the services applet, I can see that that is retained as well, and my PI Buffer Subsystem is still running under the same custom domain service account. If you want to configure buffering for additional PI interfaces, please watch Configure PI Buffer Subsystem for PI API Interfaces.